neck. I will demonstrate to you massage of neck and upper back. We usually, if somebody injure his neck, we usually treat back and neck, upper back I mean, and neck together. I will demonstrate for you in sitting position procedure. This particular procedure in sitting position, sometimes this is just necessity, because this kind of injuries would lead to impingement syndrome, all these sprains, strains, and etc. could causing the different pathology developments, could causing pain, for example, in upper back, and cause could be in neck area and opposite. And sometime, special car accident behind somebody hit the other one, it could be injured neck and upper back together. And this why always we treat together neck and upper back. Why? Again, in sitting position, because sometimes very difficult in situation for patient to lay on stomach, this create pressure on cage, rib cage, and patient because of pain contract the muscle. This is not what we're looking for. This why we will try to treat our patients few treatment in sitting position, and of course when this is possible in laying position, the same techniques you will use. We will use arm support. By the way, this is perfect techniques and methodology to treat people in chair massage. This is very work very well. Actually, what we will do in the case of injury, most of the major factor of production of pain, this is reflectorical contraction here, because of the area of spine, and even subluxation there could cause, but this is expression, this is a lot of contraction, big group of muscles, and this produce very respectful amount, let's say this way, of pain. But if to you this method, what I will demonstrate for you in chair massage, this is great. Our meanings and direction here on this treatment will be a lot of techniques. What we will do, this is to reduce the tension of muscles. And this is where the chair massage come. A lot of people carry stress in upper back and neck. And the actual expression of stress, this is tension of muscles. And chair massage, one of the ideas, this is to reduce the tensions of muscles, and this work very well. And here around cranium, under, we will place our knuckles. Gradually we will apply pressure. We will communicate with our patient. If it's enough, let me know. It's enough?
Yes.
We will stay like this 30 seconds. This kind of compression causes very, very effective in reduction, cause reduction of tension of side muscles, the neck tensions. 30 seconds. Yeah. After, we will spray the lotion on upper trapezius. We will place our fist here. Apply initial pressure. Little by little, we will move. Apply initial pressure, we stay in this, and we will move. Of course, communication, we ask our patient if he will experience some pain. Let us know if there's too much pressure. Never force, even you think or feel what you can have to go stronger. 7, 8 times. Initial pressure and directional pressure, like to stretch. After this, I will move on opposite side. And I will perform petrissage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Other, every position is 3-4 movement. Go to initial position and I will perform petrissage number 2. 1, this is hand after hand. The time we will discover the trigger points, performances of petrissage or reports of our patients. Only with stumps we cannot, an area of cervical spine, we cannot, neck I mean, we cannot apply with elbow to pressure. Here in upper back, lower back, yes, but not the cervical spine. You discover the trigger points and you can go gradually and to apply trigger point stimulation. In this particular area, we can use knuckles and elbow in order to perform trigger point stimulation. We done with neck, and actually most of the cases one on one side our patient complain and pain, but this is both side, of course we will do on both side, and chair massage in order to prevent or to treat stress phenomenons, we will use both sides. Here we will use elbow, we are applying and pressure and strip by strip up and down. Here we do not affect with this movement, when we work on level of heart, we do not affect the flow of veins blood. That's why we can move up and down on this particular level. It's like this, strip by strip, all area we covered. And kind of kneading. 1, 2, 3, 4 times on every position. We will discover trigger points. Put trigger point, finger, we exchange an elbow in here gradually, with elbow possible, to do trigger point stimulation with thumbs also, like this, you can do with thumbs, and the same idea, 30 seconds on every particular trigger point. Now we will ask our patients to move his arm behind, and now if he cannot, and some of them cannot, do not force, it could be like this or just down, it depends. You see, immediately the scapula extends out with support of other hands, and we will go under scapula. This took for me like 5 minutes average. And of course, we know this 15 minutes must be performed this way. We will do this again sets. And of course, with communication with our patient, we will ask him how the pressure, and we can increase. We can go a little bit deeper.